Hey there, Benjamin from LoveStarter here, welcome back. In this video, you're going to learn how to add Google Analytics to WordPress, and we're going to be using the latest version of Google Analytics, which is called Google Analytics 4, or GA4 for short. There are two steps to add Google Analytics to WordPress. First, you'll need to create a Google Analytics property, and then you'll need to add the Google Analytics tracking code to all of the pages of your WordPress site. You can complete these steps separately, or if you want to get started as quickly as possible, you can complete both steps without leaving WordPress. Let's head to WordPress to take a look. To get up and running quickly, I recommend using Google's SiteKit plugin. This is Google's official plugin for WordPress. To install the plugin, let's select Plugins, and then Add New. Let's search for SiteKit. And let's click Install Now for the SiteKit by Google plugin. Now let's click Activate. Before we configure the plugin, I want to mention that there are different ways you can add Google Analytics to your WordPress site. You can use a plugin, like we're going to cover, you can add the tracking code to your template file, or you can use Google Tag Manager. The quickest way to get up and running is by using Google's SiteKit plugin. It doesn't provide many features, but it's maintained by Google, it's free, it's pretty easy to use, and it embeds some key metrics from your reports directly inside WordPress. Okay, now let's click Start Setup. We can see there are a few steps to complete, so let's click Sign In with Google. And we need to sign in with our Google account. If you've already created a Google Analytics account and property that you'd like to install on WordPress, then make sure you log in using the account you use for Google Analytics. This could be your Gmail address, your Google Workspace address, or the login you use to access other services from Google. And if you haven't created a Google Analytics account and property yet, then just make sure you log in using the account you'd like to use to access Google Analytics in the future. Let's sign in. Enable all of the access options, and let's click Continue. And let's click Add Site. Now we can click Go to My Dashboard. We can see that the SiteKit plugin has automatically connected WordPress to Google Search Console, but we also want to install Google Analytics. So let's select Connect Service under Google Analytics. We need to sign into our Google account again. And click Continue. If you already have a Google Analytics account and property you would like to install on WordPress, then you can select the account from the drop-down. And then the property. If you are connecting an existing property, then you need to select a Universal Analytics property, which is the older version of Google Analytics, and a GA4 property. For example, if we select a GA4 property, then we need to choose a corresponding Universal Analytics property. Or if we select a Universal Analytics property, then we need to choose a corresponding GA4 property. If we select a different Google Analytics account, and this account only has a GA4 property, then SiteKit will create a Universal Analytics property for us. So if you have an existing account and property you want to use, then just follow the prompts and then click Configure Analytics. But if you want to get up and running for the first time, then you won't have an existing Google Analytics account or property. In this case, select the drop-down under Account and choose Set up a new account at the bottom. Then we need to name our Google Analytics account, An account in Google Analytics is like a folder. You can use it to set up Google Analytics for your business or organization. Then, if you need to set up Google Analytics for someone else, you can simply create another account. You can name your account anything you like. I'm going to name mine LovesData. Next, we need to name our property. A property is used to collect data from your WordPress website. I suggest using the same name that you use for your website. So I'm going to name mine LovesData. And on the right, we need to name our view. Each view is a collection of reports, and views are only available in Universal Analytics, so the older version of Google Analytics. Since we're focused on GA4, I'm just going to leave the default name. Now you need to choose your country and time zone for your reports. We can see a message telling us that we'll be creating both types of properties in our new Google Analytics account, so that's good. Now let's click Create Account. We need to choose our Google account again. Authorize access and click Continue. You need to agree to Google's Terms of Service. Next, you can choose the data sharing options for your account. In most cases, I recommend enabling all of the data sharing options. And let's click I accept. Now let's click Go to my dashboard. We can now see that Google Analytics has been connected. This means we've created a new Google Analytics account and property and installed it on our website without leaving WordPress. You'll now be able to select Analytics under Sitekit. And once you've started collecting data, you'll see an overview of key metrics right within WordPress. Since we only just set everything up, we can see there is a message saying Google Analytics is gathering data. So if you check back tomorrow, you'll see some quick insights here. In the meantime, let's head to Google Analytics. To do this, let's open a new tab and enter analytics.google.com. Since I'm still logged into the Google account I used to configure Sitekit, we can see Google Analytics automatically loads. We're currently looking at the GA4 property for my WordPress site. You can tell it's GA4 because there are four icons on the very left of the interface. If we select the current property at the top, we can then see the Google Analytics account we created. And there are two properties inside the account. The second property is our Universal Analytics property that Sitekit automatically created for us. You can select this, and then the reporting view to open Universal Analytics. Let's head back to the GA4 property. And let's select Real Time. This report lets you see if anybody is on your website right now. We can see lots of zeros for my WordPress site, so let's open a new tab. And I'm going to enter the URL of my WordPress site. We can navigate to the blog post. And now let's head back to Google Analytics. We can now see that data is being collected into the reports. You'll need to wait at least a day or so before you can begin using the other reports in Google Analytics. So I recommend checking back tomorrow and start exploring all of your reports. So that's how you can quickly get up and running with Google Analytics 4 on your WordPress site. To learn even more about the reports and other configuration options available in GA4, please take a moment to check out my other videos and resources. I've included links in the description below this video. Have you installed GA4 on WordPress? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. See you in the next video.